I am Suhas. I am heading the business performance for Doha Bank. Just a brief of Doha Bank for people who don't know what Doha Bank is. We are a 36-year-old bank based out of Doha, Qatar. Our footprint is visible in 14 countries right now. Countries right from UAE, Kuwait, Australia, UK, Singapore, Hong Kong, and off late. We are now about to start our operations, full-fledged operations in India. I am today I am being accompanied with my India team. They are burning the midnight oil to make this branch full-fledged operations in India to be started before the end of March. So that's our target. We are a listed company on Qatar Exchange, and we are considered as one of the most high-yielding stocks on the Qatar Exchange. In line with our Qatar National Vision 2030, our CSR model has been devised. Sorry for the distortion. Basically, I'm seeing the social pyramid has got shifted, but that was not meant. But it is based on social, environmental, as well as economic initiatives, encompassing all the stakeholders, including the customers, employees, society, regulator, investors, government, everybody is encompassed into the model. We have a very highly supportive 8-people board who drives our corporate social responsibility. Out of these eight board members, 5 of them are non-executive directors, out of which 2 are independent directors. In terms of our economic visibility, we have shown a tremendous shareholder value creation over the last one decade or so. It is visible, these are our 5-year numbers, basically quarter 3 onward, because of the full year numbers are still under preparation. Okay, we have been a consistent performance across all the parameters, business parameters, financial parameters that we could name. We are considered as one of the benchmarks in the Middle East banking region in terms of return on assets as well as return on equity is concerned. There are quite a few programs that we run under the corporate social responsibility. Just to sum up some of them, we have got almost like what we have achieved till date is almost 21 hours of staff training on an individual basis. We have provided our staff with an access of around 3,500 programs, training programs from ICT Qatar. We maintain a very high level of localization rate of around 19%, and a similar rate is being maintained even across all other operations where we, in whichever country we are part of, where we are operating. Now we have started a new program where we have started posting Qatari nationals across our entire international network. So that is another key initiative that we have taken. On our other initiatives, we have a periodic customer service. We have an award-winning Tawasol, which is a customer service center, which we have established. We maintain full norms on transparency, both at the local as well as the global standards. We run a lot of beach cleanup drives and replanting activities. We do green conferences, green quiz, green seminars, and we have our trademark Aldana Green Run, which was in its 10th year this year. For people who understand what it is, it is similar to your Standard Chartered Mumbai Marathon that you see. These are some of our global environmental seminars that we have conducted, wherever our footprint is there, right from Turkey, Japan, Singapore, Washington. Today I will be talking about 2 main projects for which we have been recognized with this award. One is the Eco Schools program. Generally, parents are supposed to teach their parents, teachers, everybody is supposed to teach a student what he is supposed to. This is one program which is a complete 180 degree from what we have learned. Here we have chosen the student as the central point of focus, and from student the knowledge is being passed on and the pressure is being generated on to the parents, teachers and society at large to drive ecological curriculum, that what we call it eco curriculum basically. Okay, we launched this program almost like 3 years back, and we have reached and it is applicable to any school which has got it might be pre primary, primary, secondary, universities, any kind of school it is applicable. Where we proactively basically provide them a platform where the schools proactively participate in the implementation of good environmental practices such as reduction of carbon footprint, increasing the eco-consciousness and supporting the children. Basically, we support the children to become an advocate at a very young age. The program has been tremendously successful in partnering with almost 32 schools as of now. And the student action teams have been formed in each of these 32 schools, and they are driving various projects within their school campuses. Some of the projects which just highlight are like they are cultivating vegetable gardens. I know it's very easy to talk in India about vegetable gardens, etc. But guys, please come down to Qatar and you will understand what a vegetable garden means. Okay, and wastewater management, or even waste management in terms of composting and paper recycling, creating arts from waste, then campus case force. The ultimate goal of this initiative is to create a long-standing impact on the Qatar economy locally. And what we have envisioned for this is whenever we have a footprint, we will be taking this program to the next level. We have already started our efforts in UAE and Kuwait on this part, and we hope we'll be fairly successful in the same way which we have been successful in Qatar all these years. The second creation that we did is, for all you know that Qatar is a society with high amount of riches and high amount of poor working together, coexisting with a multi-diversity in the country over there. Due to the recent developments that have happened in the petroleum gas industry, as well as in terms of getting the real estate sector in line with the football trade, etc., the surge in construction activity and other economic activities has gone very high. Due to less amount of native population, what we have seen is a lot of blue collar migrant workers have moved into Qatar, and there is a dearth of banking facility for this segment completely. And today the population is in the range of around 30-40% of the overall population, which is like a blue collar population, migrant workers, and there is no banking facility for this segment. So we decided that we will provide them with some access to banking, and with the help of Qatar government and the Qatar local central bank, we have worked towards a wage protection system where the salary is credited directly to the account. We have opened account for these workers, and we are now directly crediting salaries to their account on a timely, accurate, and safe manner. What this direct crediting is doing is basically we are taking out all the middlemen and probably any kind of exploitation that are happening in this space. Secondly, these guys tend to, most of their money is either consumption or it is tend to be remitting back to their home countries. So what we have provided them is the facility to remit this money at the most competitive rate in the local space without encouraging a lot of other business intermediaries to take undue advantage out of this okay. And further leveraging on the digitization, we have basically started providing them with mobile based SMSs, mobile based remittances, which is quite a nice product which has caught on very well, and we have been in a position to almost penetrate 80% of our target market in this particular segment with this. Some of the awards and recognitions we have received during last 2 years is basically we have received the best bank in Qatar from the UK Financial Times. We have received the best regional commercial bank from in the Middle East by Bank of Middle East. We have received best commercial bank of Qatar as well as best customer loyalty program from IFM magazine. We are received the best CSR program in Arab world in 2012 as well as in 2014. And of course, as Professor Paul mentioned, we have been quite a frequent in the Golden Peacock Global Awards. Some of our other green products and services, we just put it across. So we have got a green account, we have got a credit card, we have got a D-Bank SMS platform. We have got a separate website for green banking, which we call it Doha Bank Green website. And we have always been innovative, and hopefully next year again we will be coming back with some more innovation, especially in the space of ecology and environmental. Thanks, you ready.
Thank you for that.